A warm welcome to all of you as we begin this day, this week, given to us by our gracious and loving God. Thank you for joining us in prayer. I'm Father Ron, and this is the God Minute. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 126. When the Lord brought back the exiles of Zion, we thought we were dreaming. Then our mouths were filled with laughter, on our tongues, songs of joy.
Then the nations themselves said, "What great deeds the Lord worked for them! What great deeds the Lord worked for us! Indeed, we were glad."
Bring back our exiles, O Lord, as streams in the south, those who are sowing in tears will sing when they reap.
They go out full of tears, bearing seed for the sowing. They come back with a song, bearing their sheaves.
Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 4, verses 7 through 10. Brothers and sisters, we hold this treasure in earthen vessels, that the surpassing power may be of God and not from us. We are afflicted in every way, but not constrained, perplexed, but not driven to despair, persecuted, but not abandoned, struck down, but not destroyed, always carrying about in the body the dying of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may also be manifested in our body. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I wonder when the last time was you looked closely at someone's hands. Do you remember what they look like? Do you recall what came to your mind and heart? I can tell you that this is not a common practice. Sure, there is the wave of the hand in saying goodbye, or the extension of the hand in a business greeting. There's even the extension of our hands in friendship. But in these moments, there is little time to notice any markings. Yet there are times when the opposite happens, and we find ourselves noticing someone's hands. For me, this experience takes me to my Father's hands. Even now, if I close my eyes, I can see them. My Father's hands could tell a story. I could see in them calluses in his fingers and palms. I could see scars of different sizes and shapes marking the convex surfaces of his hands. And without even touching them, I could tell they were rough, strong, firm, and solid hands. They were the kinds of hands fit for a carpenter whose craft demanded manual agility and surrender. Not unlike the hands of a mechanic, cook, farmer, or surgeon, my Father's hands carried about the markings of a life lived with and for others. Are there hands of a friend, family member, or stranger that tell a story for you? What markings and story do your own hands carry about? What story do your hands manifest to others? St. Paul tells us that our hands and bodies carry the dying of Jesus. In us, others can see the marks of affliction, perplexity, persecution, abandonment, and brokenness. Our hands and bodies are those fit for the followers of Christ, revealing to others the depth and length of our walk with Jesus. It is in the marks of our hands and bodies that others also can see the power and glory that surpasses all human effort. Beyond affliction, beyond perplexity, others can see the grace of resilience that comes with faith. Beyond subjection, brokenness, and death, others can recognize the freedom, wholeness, and life that comes from encountering and loving Christ. The sign of the cross that marks our bodies in self-sacrifice and love for others already points to the treasure of grace we hold in earthen vessels. Today, St. Paul encourages us to manifest these treasures of faith, hope, and love that we carry about so that others may see the power of God. Let us in prayer then extend our hands to each other and embrace the story they tell us. Amen.
Before we pray our Father, let's take a moment and just call to mind those prayers, those faces of those we love that we're lifting to the Lord in prayer. And together, in the words Jesus himself taught us, we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, I do trust in you. Help my lack of trust. Please make me aware of the ways you constantly embrace me and draw me into your heart. And help me to be a more trustworthy person for others. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before we end, a special call out to all of you out there whose name is James. Happy Feast Day, and thank you and everyone else for joining us today in prayer. It's just a beautiful thing to recognize and, well, kind of to be amazed at the fact that we've been given another day to love, to laugh, to eat, to drink wine. Oh, thank you, God, and to all of you. May God's blessing be upon you as you go forth in this day. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We'll see you tomorrow, friends.